In this video, you will learn how to create content in Dolby Vision for social media with Final Cut Pro. We will guide you through each step, from setup to final export. Let's dive in. First, make sure your Final Cut Pro system is compatible with HDR. Apple introduced Dolby Vision compatibility in Final Cut Pro version 10.5.3. While the HDR support is primarily influenced by the software version rather than the operating system, keep in mind that newer Final Cut Pro versions may require an up-to-date Mac OS. To fully benefit from the latest features, we recommend having the latest version of Mac OS installed. Please refer to the Apple website for a list of Mac models that support HDR. To create Dolby Vision HDR content in Final Cut Pro, it's essential to have an HDR-capable display for editing and color grading. Options include a MacBook Pro equipped with a built-in XDR display, or an external HDR monitor such as an Apple Pro Display XDR. In this video, we will demonstrate this workflow using a MacBook Pro with a built-in XDR display. First, go to System Settings, Displays, and set the preset to HDR Video, P3ST 2084. This setting will ensure the most accurate HDR representation. Then, launch Final Cut Pro. As we're working with Dolby Vision HDR, the initial step is to establish an HDR library. Navigate to File, New, Library. Specify the library name and location. Then click Save. Keep in mind that Final Cut Pro typically generates an SDR library by default, so it's essential to modify it to HDR. Click Modify, and adjust the color processing to Wide Gamut HDR. Now you are ready to create your Dolby Vision project in this library. Go to File, New, Project. Set a project name and set the resolution and frame rate based on your preference. Set the color space to Wide Gamut HDR, Rec 2020 PQ. Then right-click or press Command-I to import your source materials. You have the option to utilize source videos recorded natively in Dolby Vision by a mobile phone or other HDR content from DSLR or vlogging cameras. To fully harness the wide color gamut and dynamic range of HDR, please avoid predominantly using SDR source materials. For an accurate final output, we recommend bringing up the PQRGB scope as a reference. Click View, select Video Scopes. This is a handy guide to keep your HDR visuals within a 1000 nit palette. HDR allows for higher contrast and more lifelike images, but you should avoid pushing the highlight or shadow to the point of clipping or crushing. If you want to incorporate an SDR bumper or graphic into your video, like this one, utilize the HDR tools to convert the color space from SDR to HDR to align with the timeline color space setting. Set the mode from SDR to HDR PQ and the peak brightness at 203 nits. Then utilize the mix control to fine-tune the luminance to your desired level. Titles and graphics can be added without limitations. However, for a pleasing visual experience for your viewers, the luminance of the title should be adjusted where necessary according to your HDR background image. For color grading, use tools like the color wheels and hue/saturation curves. Balance your shadows, midtones, and highlights to make your footage pop. This is particularly effective in HDR, as you have more room to play with contrast and color depth. Experiment with saturation and hues to enhance the mood. HDR can handle higher levels of saturation without looking unnatural. However, it's easy to overdo it. Use the vector scope to ensure skin tones and primary colors remain natural looking. By toggling the effects, you can compare your grading to the original look. It's impressive, isn't it? You have done the hard work, now it's time to share your content with your audience in Dolby Vision. Navigate to File, Share, and choose Export File. Go to Settings, select the format as Apple Devices, and set the video codec to HEVC Dolby Vision. Set the resolution to UHD. Click Next, and specify the file name and the render location. Once the render is complete, your video is ready to dazzle on any Dolby Vision device, or make a splash on your social media channel.